Alright, today I'm going to teach you how to do this kind of probability distribution question. This kind of question is actually is quite easy, but you need to know some concept. For this kind of graph here, the one thing is very important is you need to know all the probability add up together must always equals to 1. Because for probability, when something must happen, it's always 1. So over here, very important concept is you have all the coordinate here, and then you should know all these coordinates add together must equals to 1. And each of the coordinate here, actually, you can see the probability over here. So I can easily find a k by using that concept. So therefore, the first one is what? 1 over 16. The second one will be plus 1 over 4. The next one will be k. The next one will be 1 over 4 again. Last one will be 1 over 16. All plus together must equals to 1. Okay, this is how you can find the value of k here. And then you should like plus quickly here. This is 1, 4 is 5. 5 is 4 is 9, 10. So here will be k will equals to 1 minus 10 over 16. And then you can easily get the answer, which is 6 over 16. Or you simplify, it should be 3 over 8. Alright, this is how I find a k. The second thing is you need to find the probability when x is bigger or equals to 3. So therefore, what I will get is x must equals to 3 and also x must bigger equals to 4. And then I plus both of them together because both of these terms, x is bigger or equals to 3. And what's the probability of them? Then you can read from the graph easily. When x is equals to 3, you will get 1 over 4. When x is equals to 4, you will get 1 over 16. So if you plus them together, you should be easily get 5 over 16. Yeah, this is how we get the answer for part B.